さ、very unorthodox, kind of unethical. Probably, definitely, very, very unprofessional. I'm on a lot. Layers. It's funny how onion is spelled, right? You spell it O-N-I-O-N. Is it really onion spelled U-N-I-O-N? Onion. So if union spelled U and I went union, then why should it be unity instead of unity? I don't want to get sidetracked. As I was saying, as a woman, you should never want to be treated. See, certain aspects of the government want you to think that. You should never wanted to be treated equally to a man. You should want to be treated equally to another woman. To a man, you should want to be treated fair. You see, as a woman, you are afforded a certain grace. Do you not know who you are? Do you not? I'm here to remind you. Is why there's an attack on your species. Thought about you. There's a certain envy there. Men, certain men look at they not only look at us as their counterparts, but they look at us as we, the species, that the Creator chose to make vessels out of. The reproduction of our own species. He didn't choose them, chose us. That you can. Who do you think is the salt of the earth? He would spell it, he would understand that earth equals woman. We are the lifeblood. We are the heart. That's why man referred to earth as You want to be treated equally, do you? Then let's say that you commit a crime. You're sentenced to prison. But whilst in prison, you found out that pregnant. Would you ask your lawyer to ask the judge for leniency? But you do not want to have a child in prison. You would, wouldn't you? You know what it feels like to have a child in prison? Do you? The thing is, men go to prison all the time. Men go to jail all the time. And when they're in jail, they have children being born all the time. But what is the difference? What is the difference? You see? But you want leniency as a woman, as a vessel carrying the lineage of another human, of the human race. You want leniency. You see, but the enemy, because this is an attack from the enemy, what the enemy will have you think is that there is no difference. You see, as a woman, you cannot have it both ways because men do not have it both ways. I am here to reiterate how important it is for you to know you are as a woman. As a woman, you are automatically listening. Please listen to me if you do nothing else. Because some of you women, you talk too much and you're so belligerent and you're so combative. Be quiet. As a woman, you automatically come under the protection. It is in a man's DNA to protect the weaker species. Does that rub you the wrong way? I said weak. Are we not? Physically. You don't understand, do you? Do you understand? I will teach you the key to life as a woman. As a woman, teach you the key to life. key to life as a woman is integrity. Key to life as a woman is understanding. I think I need to put a disclaimer on there that this is just for women. Men have they have a way of coming to women's spaces, and you really have to put that. This is for ladies, females only. I'm going to talk very candid with you because, as women, that is what we do. I'm not going to hold any grudges. Cannot get both ways, my dear. You cannot want to be protected and not respect. Giving reverence, not acknowledge. I'm not speaking about anyone specifically, any one man specifically. This is just generally, generalizing. Because what the enemy would have you think as a woman is that you don't know what the enemy's job is. It's to create division. Do you know what I saw the other day? I saw that. Have you ever heard of a bag baby? Yeah. They're actually trying to create, have babies without the creator's vessel. In other words, without you. It was like a baby in a bag. And so there. To make what they're doing valid and to make. To sell you. To sell you what they're doing. They say we're trying to take the pain of women giving childbirth away. She wouldn't have to stop her daily routine to have a child, that, you know, they're going to make all kind of excuses. It's going to make it. They're trying to take your womanhood from your femininity, the very thing that God created you to be. You've heard what the men have been saying, right? Even in the church, pastors have been saying, said, we women have become masculine. But whose fault is that? Whose fault is that?